Yesterday, we announced our largest ever support for business in Victoria. We're continuing that today with a number of initiatives, as the Premier's indicated. The first of those I want to go to is $100 million of support for sole traders, for those hardest hit by restrictions. So that will apply to those sole traders who are tenants or licensees in a commercial premises or location, and who will be closed, heavily restricted, or restricted under the second step. They will be grants of $3,000. We think that will support around 33,000 sole traders across the state. So that will be those traders who work in areas like accommodation and tourism, some non-permitted retail, media and film production, gyms, creative studios, outdoor entertainment, private museums and galleries. So there'll be a whole range of sole traders who will be supported under that initiative. As I think many people are aware, primary income support for sole traders has been provided by the Commonwealth and through JobKeeper. We've been focusing our efforts primarily on those businesses which employ people, but the two levels of government have provided complementary support. This new sole trader initiative is a recognition of the serious challenges that many sole traders have faced. It will allow tens of thousands of them to help pay their overheads, to give them the opportunity to emerge on the other side and recover strongly. We have been supporting sole traders through a range of other initiatives already, including the Commercial Tenancy Relief Scheme, the support program for regional tourism accommodation providers, the Sustaining Creative Workers Fund, which Minister Foley announced, and some of the other supports like Upskill My Business, mentors and mental health support, and indeed the digital vouchers that we announced yesterday. There's also a $100 million Melbourne City Recovery Fund that will provide grants to businesses to move their activities outdoor, to fund COVIDSafe events and indeed new infrastructure as we head into the warmer months, and as people are welcomed back into the CBD. That's a partnership with the City of Melbourne, and I would just like to add my thanks to those of the Premier, to the Lord Mayor. She's been a great partner in this, and it's wonderful to be able to collaborate with the City of Melbourne on this initiative. It will support something like 16,500 businesses which are registered in the City of Melbourne. Those businesses support north of 470,000 jobs, so it's an incredibly important part of our economy, and a lot of those businesses have been enormously impacted by the restrictions which have been required to combat this global pandemic. So of that $100 million, $30 million will be provided in grants to small and medium businesses to help pay for tables, plastic screens, umbrellas, and all of the apparatus needed for outdoor hospitality, to reconfigure spaces, to convert areas like rooftops and courtyards for outdoor use. And we will be consulting along with council with CBD businesses to finalise the details of that grants program over the coming days and weeks. There'll be another $30 million to support COVIDSafe events and cultural activities in the CBD to attract visitors back to the city once it's safe to do so, and once the city is more is out of restrictions in obviously a much greater way than it is now. And there will be another $40 million going towards providing physical improvements to the CBD streetscape, whether that's about bike lanes, wider footpaths, bollards, and the like. So as the Premier's indicated, this will, I think, utterly transform the city. And I think not just for this summer, it's going to be something that I think Victorians will love and appreciate, and will create a new, I think, al fresco environment for CBD dining, which will be, I suspect, enjoyed for many summers hence. Outside the CBD, there is an $87.5 million outdoor hospitality support package as well, and that will drive innovation and creativity in the way we model our hospitality offerings. So, $58 million of that will be paid in grants of up to $5,000 to businesses to help pay for, again, umbrellas, furniture, screens, etc., but also to invest in training, and to invest in advertising and the like. Those grants will be available to both licensed and unlicensed businesses, restaurants, takeaway food businesses, pubs, bars, and clubs with a payroll under $3 million, and we estimate about 11,000 businesses outside the CBD will benefit from that. And another $30 million will go to local councils to help them implement the streamlined permit enforcement and monitoring processes that will be necessary to make this work and to support expanded outdoor hospitality. So those grants will be up to $500,000 for metropolitan councils and those councils which cover regional cities, and rural councils will be eligible for grants of up to $250,000. And some of that money can be passed on to businesses in the form of reducing or waiving permit fees, but they can also be invested in infrastructure like streetscaping. So that is some detail of the package. I'm sure there'll be a lot of detail that's sought. We'll be able to provide you with that information either during this briefing, if possible. Otherwise, we'll provide it to you afterwards. And with those words, I will hand you back to the Premier.